Hello and welcome. Today I want to talk about OwnCloud installation. OwnCloud is a cloud-based storage solution, pretty much like Dropbox, Google Drive, and the like. The main difference between these solutions and OwnCloud is where the data is stored. So in products like Dropbox, for example, the data is stored in the servers of the service provider. If you're using, say, OneDrive, the data is stored in Microsoft servers. With OwnCloud, on the other hand, you're using your own server. So we're talking about local storage. As for pricing, with Dropbox and the like, you get a few gigabytes for free, but you have to pay if you want more. With OwnCloud, you're only limited by the storage capacity of your server. Notice that if the server is behind the router, it will only be accessible in the local network. To have public access to the data, the server must have public IP. Okay, let's move on to the installation itself. The installation process is made of quite a lot of steps, but luckily the guys from OwnCloud made a really detailed installation guide. So we're going to just follow it and not think too much, which is always good. Okay, I have the installation page open. I leave a link in the video description below, and let's log into the server with SSH. By the way, I'm using an Ubuntu server, but I'm planning to make another video for Debian servers. So if Debian is your server of choice, watch that video. I leave a link to it as well. Now, a lot of the commands that we are about to run require root privileges. So instead of using sudo every single time, I'm just going to sudo bash. And now we're running everything as root, so it should save us some headache. So we're starting with the preparation. Let's update our system. They now create a helper script that will be useful later on. And let's make it executable. We now need a whole bunch of required packages, and we're going to install them all at once. We now need another PHP package that apparently was removed from the official repository. So we're going to add it to the repositories and then we will install it. And let's configure Apache and its file structure. We now need to create the MySQL database. In the guide, they used password as the database password, but I strongly recommend that you use something more secure than just password. Okay, let's download OwnCloud itself. And we now want to install it. Notice that since I changed the database password, I need to tell OwnCloud the correct password. So I'll copy the next command to a temporary text file so it's easier to edit it. Moreover, we need to create an administrator. That's the user that creates normal users and determines how OwnCloud is configured. I'll call my administrator user Elbow. Great, OwnCloud was successfully installed. Let's move on. And let's set up the needed cron jobs. And we need a few more commands to wrap up the installation. And we're finally done. OwnCloud is installed and supposed to be accessible. Let's try to access it by using the server's IP in the browser. Notice that when you type in the server's IP, some browsers are going to assume that we're trying to access it using HTTPS. But since we didn't set up SSL on the server, we're going to use plain HTTP. So be aware of that. Great, and we can see the OwnCloud login page. Right now, we only have one user, that's Elmo, the administrator. So let's log in as administrator. And we logged in. If you want a quick getting started tutorial for OwnCloud configuration and usage, I'm planning to make one soon, so I'll leave a link to this as well. That would be all for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.